I got a little silver Sharpie, hopefully I can mark. I'm not sure I'm going to get it. I'll mark the bottom. Yeah. So this sucker right here will help me get in there at 90 degrees. There's not enough room to do it the other way. Cannot see under there to save my life. Oh, there we go. Alright, I'm gonna have to drill a new hole for that. All right, time for the instructions. So now I'm going to run all the wires, at least somewhat temporarily. Like I'm not going to hook them up, but I'm going to terminate them all and get the heat shrink on them and all that. The very first wire is the ground from the fan itself. So that this plug goes directly to the fan. The positive used to go to a relay, now it's going to go directly to the positive on top of the alternator. And the ground goes down to this terminal down here. I have a really good end on this already, so I'm not going to use the one that they sent to me, and that goes on the fan post. So I'm just gonna stick it on there and loosely put the nut on just so it doesn't flop around. And then the ground post of that goes to ground. So it's gonna go back up to here. And I'm gonna make a wire for that. So I'm using number 10, or 10 gauge rather, wire, automotive wire, which I think is what they recommend, 8 or 10. Now I am going to use their connectors on this. The other thing is, I solder everything. So all my terminal ends on this whole car are soldered on. And I'll do the same with this. So I'll slip a piece of heat shrink tube over it and go to town. And I'm not sure I have a piece of heat shrink. I've got a big one and a small one. I'm not sure I have one that'll work. All right, found a piece that'll work. So when I do these, I lightly crimp. Not lightly, I mean, I crimp it on there, but I don't kill it. I do want room in there for solder to get around. And actually, I think that bigger piece of heat shrink is what I'm gonna have to use. Let me see what happens when I shrink that sucker on there. Yeah, that did the trick. Alrighty. So that's going to go from this screw. I'm going to have to drill it out. I'll probably go down this side. Actually, I'll go down this side. Same deal, except I got to drill out this connector to fit on there, which I hate doing. All right. There we go. Perfect. All right, that sucker is snug. Reaches down there perfectly, I think. Oh yeah. All right, so I'll get that out of the way. We got the fan one. So I'm gonna tie these back together. These were the original power for the whole deal. And it's gonna go back up under here, under the, like where all these other wires go. So I think I don't even really need to cut it. Let me see. And this is all gonna get wire loom back on it when I'm done, I think. I'm gonna get rid of this little thing. This is going to get a butt splice. Fortunately, I have a butt splice that's got heat shrink built into it. So I just happen to have one and it's the right size. I'm going to go ahead and use it. I might put a piece of heat shrink over it anyway, just to tie it all together. So change plans. I took a regular butt splice apart, like took the sheathing off the outside of it. And I'm going to use it. I think it's going to give a better connection. Setting these on there to hold the wire. Let's see if the small, small heat shrink fits perfectly. Sweet. I've got this old sheath on this wire. I'm going to peel off the end of it. Pull that over. And I'm going to put the... maybe I'm not. I was hoping I could use this big piece of heat shrink to tie these things together just to make it look better. But I'm not sure it's going to work. Might have to put a little electrical tape on it. I think these big wires are really important. This is a 40 amp circuit. So, you know, this is the part of the circuit that all that current for the fan is running through. And it needs to be, the joints need to be really good. You don't want a risk of them being loose or failing. Like if they're loose, they'll just burn themselves up. Even if that fuse is a tiny bit loose in there, it'll cook itself in a heartbeat. So it might look like overkill, but this is the largest, other than the starter, this is the largest circuit in the whole car. So it's a pretty critical one. And so it'll go under there once the camera's out of the way. So that's that. The next wires I really want to do are the sensor wires. And in order to do those, I've got to insert that inline sensor. So I got to take that bottom hose assembly off. Let's see how close I can get to it. This one, probably pretty easy. That other one, going to be a little tricky. Yep, that one was a piece of cake. Okay, let's see the next one. And I marked that hose, this metal pipe where it enters that hose. Oh yeah, there we go. Just so I know how much I have to work with when I cut it. I'm only cutting that end. All right. And this is a pipe I made. I just bought some mandrel bends and sorted it out, welded it all together. All right. So this sensor goes in here. I think the instruction said it should face up. Not sure why. Let me see if I can find anything. Well, it's supposed to go on the top of the outflow port. Okay, so because I'm using the inline one, I'm just going to face it up. Go ahead and tighten this sucker back down. Seems pretty good. And now I've got a piece of hose that I already prepped.
Fantastic. And now I need a measurement. So from the original silicon hose, 2 5/8, and then it's going to sit in there an inch. So 1 5/8 from that mark to where the edge of the pipe needs to be.